Hey, hi guys. In this video lecture, we are going to study the resistance to change, a topic of organizational development. In this topic, we are going to study the meaning and definition of resistance to change, types of resistance to change, why the people resist or change, and also the various strategies of overcoming the resistance to change. So let's start with the topic. First of all, introduction of resistance. So resistance means any hurdles or problems or hesitation to change, which will generally shown by the peoples when an HR manager or a change agent will try to bring the change in the organization. So in this way, we can say that the resistance is the incomplete transition in response to change. So this is a definition given by Bridge. And we can define the change as that any alteration in the existing system is called change. So it may be physical, chemical, mechanical, or structural, or any other kind of change in the organization. Next is the resistance to change. So resistance to change is an action taken by an individual or a group when they perceive that the change is occurring as a threat to them. It will bring the cost and benefit to the organization. Cost means it involves a lot of cost to bring the change in the organization, because the people will resist the change, and also it will brings the benefit to the organization. Because of the resistance to change, the organization may grow and it will provide the benefits to the organization. So resistance to change may take many forms, such as active or a passive. So active means it is actively shown by the employees by their behavior, and passive means it is not shown by the employees. Overt and covert. Overt means the behavior which is expressed by the behavior of employees, and covert means the resistance which is not shown by the behavior of employees. It is also shown by the individual employees, and as well as it is shown by the group of employees, which is known as organized resistance to change. It is sometimes in the form of aggressive or a timid. Aggressive means that it is shown aggressively by the strikes or a lockdown, and timid means it is hidden inside the behavior of an employee. Next is the type of resistance to change. So there are three types of resistance to change. First one is emotional, second one is political, third one is rational. So emotional resistance involves the psychological fear, psychological problems such as fear, anxiety, security, etc. These feelings are generally evoked because the people's perceptions is that when they bring about the change, so this will affect their emotional behavior. Next is the political resistance. So political resistance is about the self-image and perception of power. To minimize the impact of political resistance, be sure to involve the right people and at the right place to bring the change in the organization. Next is the rational. It occurs when the people do not have the proper knowledge or information to evaluate the change. So providing the proper information or knowledge can reduce this type of resistance. Next is why the people resist to change, which is the reasons for the resistance to change. So there are a lot of reasons because of which the people resist to change. A few of them are, so first one is threat to power. So threat to power kind of resistance is generally shown by top management. So top management resists the change because they think that it is a threat to power of their influence. They feel that new changes may challenge their authority. Their authority may become decentralized. Next reason is the group inertia. So individual resist the change because whole group do not want to change. Some of the group members want to change, but due to the fear of group, they resist the changes. Next is the organizational structure. So different type of organizational structure, design, and activities also resist the change. So for example, bureaucratic organization. So bureaucratic organizations are strict to the rules and regulations and highly decentralized. So they are less flexible to the change as they are strict and rigid as compared to organic structure. So what is organic structure? So organic structure organization is that who are more flexible to adopt the changes in the organization. If an organization structure is posing the resistance, then the structure must be changed. This needs the re-engineering effort. Next is threat to trait. So here threat means the set of skills, competencies and abilities generally the people have to perform their particular job. If the new changes is introduced, though, it may hamper their performance, job and work. So due to this fear of job incongruency, the people resist the change. Next is the resource constraint. So here the resource constraint means the limitation of resources. So any change in the organization will require the many type of resources and expenses like skilled labor, new machines, tool, technology, training cost, etc. Since the resources are scarce and limited, also costly, so people will resist to bring the change in the organization. So the last one is the limited focus on change. So the most of the time, the people generally focus on the limited area of change. So because of it, they generally resist the changes in the organization. Next is the consequences to resistance to change. So there are two consequences to the resistance to change. First one is the covert or implicit defensive behavior. So the behavior which are generally expressed and which are generally not expressed and not easily visible are called covert or implicit defensive behavior. So these are the behaviors which are generally hidden inside the behavior of an employee. So few of them are loss of loyalty to the company, loss of motivation, lower morale, less in efficiency, and the last one is absenteeism. Second one is the overt defensive behavior. So here the term overt means which are expressed and visible by the behavior of employees. These are actively shown by the employees. So these are the this may of various forms like disobedience of employees, indiscipline at the workplace, strike or lockdown of employees, and work slowdown of employees, fear loss of production, and the next one is increase in error. Next is the overcoming strategies to the change, that is how the resistance to change can be improved or overcome. So there are the lot of strategies to overcome the resistance to change. Few of them we are going to study here. So the first one under this is the participation. So those who resist the change, assign them some task so that they participate and get completely involved in it. Second one is the employee involvement. So it is used when change efforts requires more employee commitment and employee suggestions are invited, decision making power and authorities are awarded to the employees. So the next one is the effective communication. Inadequate and incomplete information may resist the change because it creates the confusion in the minds of employees. So therefore the communication should be adequate and complete and also in a proper format. So it should be free from technical jargons. It should flow freely in the organization and there should not be any communication gap. So the next one is leadership. So leadership may be either democratic or autocratic as required in the organization, because the leaders generally try to protect the interest of the weaker sections of the group. So they will provide the necessary direction, guidance and helps to the individual to overcome the resistance to change. Next one is the participation and support to individual. Discuss the problems of an individual who will resist the change and provide them the emotional support. If there are some kind of barrier, so provide them some training and development facilities so that and other resources so that they will overcome the resistance to change. Next one is the negotiation and agreement. So it is also one of the method to overcome the resistance to change. When the employees negotiate with the management, if the employees are losing something, then there is some gains also. So management must compensate with this loss and a gain, and more strict job securities may lead to the one of the gain. Next one is the training. So it is used when employees need to break the old routine and adopt the new pattern. So here the employees will learn that how to work in a team, and it is a time consuming and a costly method. Next one is the stress management. So it is used when communication, training and other kind of strategies will not work efficiently, then employees will be given the some sessions to overcome the resistance to change, and then so that they can reduce their tensions. So this is the time, also time consuming and a costly method. Next one is the coercion. So coercion means the punishment. So employees can be pressurized by the management to change. If they do not want to change, so there in this way by the fear of punishment, they generally adopt the changes in the organization. So the conclusion. So resistance to change is a normal when any organization within any organization. So resistance may occur at every stage of the organization. People oppose the change due to worries about the security and safety of their life. So various internal and external forces may affect each organization in different ways. So organization can use the various models of organizational development which help them to start the transition between implementing the change and managing resistance from the employees. So thank you very much for listening it very patiently.